God says what? Live large, live unashamed, and live audaciously. So I have titled this message, Live Large. Tell somebody, live large.
Live large.
Tell another person, live large.
Live large.
Amen. You may say, what does it mean? Pastor, you are talking about living large. Turn your Bible quickly to the book of 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians chapter 6, 11 to 13. 2 Corinthians chapter 6, 11 to 13. O ye Corinthians, our mouth is open unto you, our heart is enlarged. 12. Ye are not strengthened in us, but ye are strengthened in your own bowels. 13. Now, for a recompense in the same, I speak unto my children, be ye also enlarged. Amen. Did you see the last word? Be ye also what? Enlarged. Paul was advising the believers in Corinthians. He said, we have opened our hearts unto you, but it seems as if you are constrained. It seems as if you are just locked up in yourself. Open up yourself to us. Live enlarged. Live a large life. Don't live as if your coming to Jesus has pissed something out of you. Don't live as if you are defeated. Do not live as if your own is worst. Live as people who have received freedom in Jesus. Live as people who have been liberated. Live as people that Jesus said, I have come to give you life in abundance. But when you are living your life very low, very small, you are not manifesting the abundance of life. Because Jesus himself says in the book of John chapter 10 verse 10, the second part, he said, I have come to give you life what? In abundance. That means the life you have received is not a life of shame. Praise God. The life we have received in Jesus is not a life of what? Shame. There is nothing to be ashamed about. There's nothing that should intimidate us to make us live an average life, a mediocre life. Whether in a social place, whether in a secular place, whether in the marketplace, there is no need to live a second life, a second-hand life. The life Jesus has given to us is a big life, a bold life. The Bible said that they that do know their God, they shall be what? Strong. And they shall do what? Exploit. That is a big life. When you can talk with authority. Because Jesus says in the book of Luke chapter 10 verse 19, behold, I give unto you power, and ye shall tread upon serpent and scorpion, and nothing shall by enemies what? Hurt you. That is a bold life. So God has empowered you and myself. Tell somebody, God has empowered us. So do not live less. Let me read it from another translation. 2 Corinthians 6, 11 to 13. Another translation said, we did not fence you in. Paul was speaking. We did not fence you in when we preached the gospel to you. When you come to church, being a child of God doesn't mean that you are fenced in. Walking about with a chip. Walking about as if we are not permitted to leave because we are believers. As if we don't have a voice anymore. No, that's not what we have been called. That's what Paul is saying. He said the smallness you feel comes from within. So a lot of us, when we receive Jesus, we begin to feel too small. There is this smallness we feel. If you feel small today, that is an abnormality. Because he that's in you is greater than what? He that's in the world. So you can't feel small. When the creator of the whole universe inside of you is living there, you cannot live a little life. You cannot live as if you are begging life to honor you. You cannot live as if you are begging life to fall onto you. within. The feeling where you say, I don't have confidence, it comes from within, because you do not yet know who you are. If you know who you are, it doesn't matter your knowledge, it doesn't matter your certificate, it doesn't matter your title. As long as you are bearing the title child of God, you are qualified. Praise God. At times we feel small because we think of our past. You must disconnect from your what? Past. Because by grace we are living right now. Let's finish that scripture from another translation. So he says, your lives aren't small. Your life is not small. But you are living them in a small way. I am speaking as plainly as I can and with great affection upon your lives. He said, open up your lives. Live openly and expansively. Praise God. I love that translation. So live openly and expansively. It's a level where you walk. Somebody sees you. They are talking about you. You just move ahead and see if nothing is happening. Praise God. You just move ahead with your life. It is a life where challenges come. You look at challenges and say, you know what? He that is in me is greater than he that is in you. But when we don't live up to that, we are not living large. Tell somebody, live large. Live unashamed. And live audaciously. Amen. I looked at the dictionary to find out what does it mean to be audacious. What is, you know, in Nigeria there's something we always like that word. You have audacity in a negative way. When you speak you notice the truth and you stand your ground and say, wow, you have this audacity to speak to me like that. But there is positive audacity and there's negative audacity. Where people are unnecessarily rude. They are unnecessarily what? Rude. Like you see a child in the bus and you say, excuse me, can you move? And the child looks at you and says, what? That's a negative word, audacity. But we are called to live a positive word, audacity. That is what it means to be what? Audacious. Where you take bold steps, bold risks. Amen? Living audaciously is where you take bold risks in faith. Not just risk anyhow, but risk in faith. Where you see somebody that is very sick, you are not saying, well, I'm just a new believer, I can't pray for him. But something in you says, I am not small, I can do it. And you jump up and pray for the person. You go on the street, you go in your office, your boss is sick. And you have something in you says, don't pray for your boss, he is your boss. Something in you says, no, I am audacious, I'm going to pray for him. Sir, can I pray for you? That's what Paul is talking about. He said, you have fenced yourself in. Your life is not small, but you are living it small. If you are here, you are living your life small. Be encouraged today. Tell somebody, be encouraged. Be encouraged. Don't live it small anymore. There are a lot of things inside of you that need to come out. You think you don't know anything. But can I tell you, you know so much. It's just because you have not been utilizing them. A lot of you today, if I say, sister, next Sunday you are going to preach or you are going to share, you say, no, pastor, I don't know what to say. But can I tell you that you have a lot inside of you, but you don't know. Be audacious about it. Tell pastor, yes, I can do it. Give me the microphone. I will pray to you on Sunday. And you watch what will happen as the Holy Ghost. Sunday, I've been asked to preach. Tell me what to say. When you come out, everybody will say, wow. So you need to defeat that one smallness. Tell somebody, defeat the smallness inside of you. So Paul is saying, it is not that your life is small. Because you are born again does not make you small. Because I'm born again does not make me small. So let unbelievers not intimidate you. Never spirit preaching, let me see the prison that will contain us. But some of us, we have shut our mouths. And so they have the boldness to catch few that are speaking. God said your life is not small. So do not live it small. Amen. God wants us to live our life to the max.